Before I can answer any questions, I need an iced coffee. By the way, if you don't follow me on Instagram, you should. I'll put it somewhere here on the screen. But I just asked y'all for questions, and I screen recorded all the answers, so I'm kind of just going through right now. A lot of them are about Dev and me, so I feel like I should have him on soon, too, for like a Q&A, and we can talk about like being newlyweds or whatever, because a lot of y'all are asking about like being newly married, like how's it going, all of that. Like, why did you guys move to Texas? And again, I know this kind of involves Dev, but I don't think he'll mind me speaking on his behalf, so... Basically, Dev and I got married right before we moved to Texas, and we have dated for a super long time. We both grew up in Raleigh, and that's where we're from and where we just moved from like a few months ago. I don't know, we just like wanted to go somewhere else when we were married. There's nothing against Raleigh. I love it. Like, I'm going home in a few weeks and I cannot even contain my excitement. I'm really excited. I visited Haley a few times when we were like becoming friends and all of that, and so I had gotten to explore Texas a few times without Dev, and I just like fell in love with the area, specifically where we are. Like, I really, really like it. It's super fun. And honestly, I was like, life's kind of short, why not? And that was too when the podcast was like a big part of our life. And so I was like, you know what? Let's do it. Haley and I can record in person. It's just been really great to be in a new space. I will say I really miss my family. So I have days where I struggle, but we have so many great friends here. And I just feel like creatively, like, I feel like there's no limits for the business, and like I just feel super inspired, and I don't know, Texas did some really good things for us as a couple, so that was my really long answer to that question. What are your favorite creativity apps? Love you. Love you too. Basically for me, creatively, I would say my number one app is probably Pinterest. Oh my gosh, guys. Pinterest really inspires me, and clothes really inspire me. So for example, if I see an outfit on Pinterest that I really like with a different kind of color combination, like I'll pin that in like my colors board or whatever. And so I'm super inspired by Pinterest. Instagram is really great too, just because I follow so many creative people that I can't help but like be inspired on there. I don't know, you guys inspire me a lot. So chatting with you, figuring out like how you're feeling, what your favorite colors are, all of that like also really inspires me to create artwork for y'all. But in terms of like the actual app that I use to draw, I use Procreate. I know that's a big question I get asked a lot. How tall are you? I am 5'2". I had to think about it for a second. 5'2". How has your life been affected after you found God? That is a great question, because y'all, I need to do a whole video just on like my faith journey, because it's definitely probably not been like how you guys assume. Like, I feel like I just really found out who God was fairly recently. When I met Devin, like, his family just would talk about their faith, and Devin would talk about God in this way that I was like, I want to truly know him. Like, I really do. And so just with dating Devin and like us just having so many conversations and going to church together and everything, I feel like I've truly like found God, and my life has definitely been affected. I'll say that my worries are nearly like, I used to struggle so much with anxiety, and I just feel like I'm so like, it's all good. Like, God's got my back. Like, I know that no matter what goes on in life, like, he is there with Deb and I to go through it and navigate through it. And I just like, I don't really fear like the future as much anymore. I mean, of course, I'm human, guys, like I do, and especially with my business, you know, it's just normal to feel that way. But I feel very just relaxed in knowing that he's got us. I don't know. I really trust in the future, and I'm truly living each day and like the present moment. And that's probably, yeah, that's probably my answer for that. Are you going to do pop-up shops in Austin, Texas ever? I want to so bad. So if you followed me for a good bit back home in Raleigh, I did pop-ups all the time. Like, I would make my table really cute and bring like a few of each of our products that we sell, and I got to talk to you guys in person and just hang out with y'all. It was so fun. But with COVID, I don't really think that's going to be happening for a bit. I know that people are still doing pop-ups. I've been seeing other like makers and artists doing them, and like, of course you wear your mask and you just distance yourself, but I don't know, like I just don't know if I'm quite there yet. So eventually, yes, when COVID is not a thing anymore, I would love to do pop-ups here. Oh, do you ever want to get some sort of pet? Yes, I do. But the answer is we won't, but yes, I want one. And it's not because Devin is like, no, we can't get a pet or anything. Here's my thing. I love animals. Like, if you know me in my like true personal life, I love animals so much. Squirrels are like my favorite thing ever. Like, I love little cute animals, big animals, everything. I just love animals. Here's my thing. I love animals so much to realize that like we could not give an animal the life that it deserves right now. Yes, I would love it and take care of it, but like, we're just out doing things throughout the day, or like sometimes we're at friends' houses till late, and it's just like having a baby, I feel like. I don't know. Depending on the pet you're getting, like I know cats can be like more low maintenance, but I just don't feel like we're ready for a pet. And like with traveling hopefully coming up, even like going back home for the holidays, like I don't know how we would do that, if we would try and bring the pet on the plane, if I could have someone watch it here. Like, it's just a big thing. But yes, I really want a pet. I'm like obsessed with long-haired wiener dogs. I think they're so cute, and I really want a kitten. Like, I really want a kitten, but Devin is pretty allergic to cats, and we both want like a hypoallergenic dog. So I'm thinking one day, maybe when we have like kids, we would get a dog, but it won't be for a while. But just know I really want a pet. And so if you have pets, send me pictures of them, because I love animals so much. What filters do you use for your Instagram posts? That is a good question. I feel like I never talk about that. Right now, I would say I usually use the Tezza app. I don't know if you guys have heard of it before, but I really like the Tezza app. And that is actually too another question I get like in my DMs all the time. Whenever I do like those kind of like stop motion type videos, I always get asked like, how the heck did you do that? And the answer is the Tezza app. So she is a creator and like influencer on Instagram. She made her own app, and it has like all of her filters on it, and it's just amazing. There's so many cool things you can do. Like, you can add like glitter or just like cool grain effects, whatever. So I really like to use her app. I pay for it. I think I paid for like the yearly subscription, just because I really do use it all the time. Then another app I really like is Lightroom. I go on there just to tweak like kind of the lighting. I don't really do like a lot of the colors and true editing on there, but it is a really, really good one to use. And it is a little bit more complicated, so sometimes I just do like little tiny things in there. And another app I like to use is Visco. Right now I don't use it quite as much, but I do like Visco. I go through phases with editing. I don't know if you guys are ever like that, where like I'm using one app a lot and then I switch, because I get bored so easily. Like, I think it's just my creative like art mind. Like, I'm always wanting to switch things up or have like new colors or whatever. So yeah, right now Tezza, Lightroom, and Visco. Number one tip for Instagram growth and building an online community. So I don't want to sound like generic and annoying, and like seriously, like, yeah, there's some, I guess, hacks to Instagram, like things you can keep in mind, but I really think when it comes down to it, deep down to it, just being personal with your audience and listening to them. Like, seriously, I think about all my favorite accounts to follow, and it's the people that like I truly feel like I know. Like, they show me everything in their day. And like, of course, depending on your account, like it might not make sense to like show what you're eating. You know, if you like truly stick to like product photos and like keep your business account really professional, like that might not be something that you want to share. But I know for me, I really wanted to mix my business with my personal life. And yeah, that's icky and weird. At the end of the day, I'm so glad that I like chose to be a really big part of my business online. And because I just think it's important, especially because everything that I do is handmade. Like, I'm the one hand drawing each letter, each rainbow, each cloud, whatever. And like, I wanted you guys to know me for me, and like what's important to me, and how I act and how I talk and things I do every day. I just really wanted you guys to know me. And so I feel like that's a really big part of my Instagram growth, is just because I remember when I started to post my lettering, yeah, it did well, but it wasn't, I feel like, until I started dancing on Instagram stories and like talking to my Instagram stories. That's something that people really like when I do. And I sometimes just don't do it because I'm like, oh, I'm probably being kind of annoying. Being yourself, like, oh my gosh, be yourself. It's not fun to go on social media and see like every account like posting the same exact stuff or doing the same thing or making the same crew neck. Like, I think it's so fun to be unique in yourself, because you are you for a reason. Like, you are unique for a reason. So I just think being yourself and really listening to your followers and like what they want from you is really important. That's something I'm really trying to work on right now. For example, with my lettering, a lot of you guys want like more process videos and all of that, and so I'm like, okay, noted, like I gotta do that more. Was your first kiss with Dev? Guys, I'm gonna spill the tea. No, it was not. I had my first kiss in 7th grade and I was at a dance. It's not with Dev. I'm shocked I just did that. That is a juicy one. Okay, someone said, girl, how do you spend so much money on coffee and not go broke? Yes, I get coffee all the time. I do. I get it almost every single day out. I actually have not today. It's shocking. I don't have plans to go anywhere today, so good for me. Pat myself on the back. Here's my thought process with coffee, because yes, it is kind of expensive. It is expensive, and if you add it up, like I know it's a lot of money, but my thing is Dev and I are super good with our money in like the sense that we don't pay for stuff, like I don't know, like we don't have a lot of subscriptions, we don't pay for cable, like I don't even have Spotify premium, like there are all these things like we don't personally choose to spend our money on, and if you choose to, that's fine, but don't judge me for buying my coffees now, because like we personally, like that is kind of like our self-care, like we would rather buy a coffee every day and like go sit at a coffee shop for an hour and like get some work done, like be really productive, than like pay for something else. So, like that's just a way that we spend our money, and like it doesn't bother us at all. Definitely try and like kind of budget our money and be aware of how we're spending our money, but I'm also like, life is short. Coffee shops make me so happy. That is something Dev and I have done since we started dating. I kid you not, like we've been together for 5.5 years now, and I think about it, that is crazy. Like a huge part of our relationship has always been just like going to coffee shops and everything, so that's just something we choose to do, and like it really doesn't bother me at all. Thank you so much for watching this, even to like this point, seriously, like it all helps my channel out so much, and I just really love you guys. So fun chatting. I hope you guys learned a little bit about me, and I can definitely do another Q&A soon. I kind of want to bring Devin on for like the next one, and we can just talk about being married and like relationship stuff, because I think that would be really fun. Please subscribe to my channel if you have not already. Give this video a thumbs up. Yeah, I will chat with you guys soon. I hope you're having a great day, morning, night, whatever, whenever you're watching this. And I love you guys. Bye.